out there tells you something. I'm told I had an ancestor in the Alamo. The pride in Texas is a real thing, and I take it with me everywhere I go.
I'm a seventh generation Texan. I mean, I know that my father's family came into Texas in 1836. I know that my grandmother, Bessie Dossett, walked behind a covered wagon in 1899 from Louisiana. We like Texas and we like being Texans. So, you know, we started bringing that to the fore. And we took it, you know, obviously we took it much further when we did the Worldwide Texas Tour, and just, you know, which was just one giant piece of craziness. I mean, wow.
I guess probably about 74, a friend of mine approached me in my dressing room. I was climbing a rodeo. And he said, my boss wants to meet you. And he's the manager of ZZ Top. I said, ZZ who? Because I was in the country. So I met with Bill Ham in my dressing room, and he asked me a lot of questions about training and how much experience I'd had and stuff. And so I said, well, yes, I've trained a lot of animals. And he said, can you train a buffalo? And I said, I can train anything with hair. He said, okay, you're hired.
This is Texas, and this is that little old band from Texas, ZZ Top. ZZ Top's Worldwide Texas Tour is coming.
Bill Ham was the most sophisticated strategist of touring that I've ever seen in my life. Bill wanted to create a mystique, so they put together a tour called the Worldwide Texas Tour. And they put together a 75-foot wide stage in the shape of the state of Texas. They had four trucks painted with a continuous diorama of Texas landscapes just rolling down the highways of America. At that point, Texas was considered unsophisticated by New York people, Hollywood people. And as a result, people like Janis Joplin, who grew up in Port Arthur, Texas, pretended she was from San Francisco. Well, gradually it dawned on ZZ Top and Bill Ham, it was time for a movement for Texas pride. It was time for them to take Texas culture to the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, that little old band from Texas, ZZ Top.
Finally had a little money to make a production. You know, we never had made a production before. We didn't know how to make a production. And then, you know, some idiot, and I don't know which one of us it was, I can't remember, but it's like, let's take a buffalo. Yeah, well, let's take a longhorn steer. Well, let's take some rattlesnakes. Let's take a javelina pig. Let's take some buzzards, you know. So all of a sudden, we've got this thing, you know, seven trucks worth of thing to go out and do concerts with.
Which one's that, two?
Two.
Five? Two.
Two. He was with us last year.
This buzzard was my rodeo clown career for 42 years, and it was easy for several years. And so she's, I think we figured she's 49. Almost 6 more months, she'll be 50 years old. When ZZ asked me to come along with them, then I suggested the buzzard. She was staged behind Frank Beard. Frank used to tease him. He used to kind of tease with him and stuff, but the buzzards didn't want anybody messing with him.
The buzzards were right behind me. And if I was playing a slow blues, they would get very interested in me, like, is he dead? You know? So I start moving your arms a lot more.
Yeah!
Worldwide Texas Tour was a huge tour. I mean, it was elaborate even for the time, and it was extremely expensive. And we weren't big enough to do that. And everybody told us, but we did it. It was audacious, and we liked that. That very idea of doing that is what it means to be Texas.
It was like a circus. It was like a Texas circus. You had livestock on stage, for Christ's sake. Who'd ever done that? Who'd ever seen animals on stage with you? It was like a rodeo, a circus, and a rock show all wrapped into one.
For the band, the Worldwide Texas Tour finally, once and for all, it placed ZZ Top as, oh, those three guys from this weird place called Texas. Did you see them with the traveling zoo? So Texas at that time was starting to become discoverable. Cowboy hat sales, which had been relegated to the borders of the Great Lone Star State, was now up in, New York City at a Western wear shop. And all due in no small part to this mythical trio called ZZ Top.
Stands and beer halls that gave them their nickname of that little old band from Texas. But the down-home Texas approach looks like a solid hit with the teenagers in grassroots America.
The Worldwide Texas Tour was a grandiose outing from the beginning to the closing. We had made the rounds coast to coast and border to border. The band worked 7 days a week, and by the time we pulled it to the curb, safe to say that all three band members, we wanted to take a step back.